Wave your hand, from your one number one. From your ready for the competition. Woman and man. Wave your hand. Every man, every bitch, every fan, every deal, every wicked, every stone. Where the art and soul and passion, and the culture, Caribbean blood. When people come out of nation, it's a team in a unification. When you see them from these sacrifices, and I'm in need in a unification.
It's how we play.
Trinidad and Tobago has much to be proud of. Its native son is the record holder for the highest test and first-class scores. It has produced the Caribbean's first 100-meter Olympic champion, a gold medalist in the javelin at the London 2012 Olympics.
Trinidad and Tobago, the first time a non-European had won the gold medal in this event since 1952.
It has arguably one of the biggest cultural spectacles in its annual world-renowned carnival. Not to forget the home of Steel Pan. It can also boast of having produced women who are beautiful enough to have captured the most prestigious Miss Universe and Miss World crowns. Add one more to the list. Trinidad and Tobago will be the first Twin Island Republic to host the inaugural Limacol Caribbean Premier League semi-finals and final. It's time for the Caribbean Premier League Weekly, the show that tells you all about the biggest cricket tournament in the region. I'm Barry Wilkinson. This week we come to you from the wonderful Twin Island Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. On this week's program, we catch up with one of West Indies cricket superfans. We hear from the father of two of Trinidad and Tobago's top players, who shows us some moves of his own. And the son, Dwayne, that will be leading the Trinidad and Tobago Red Steel. Plus, a behind-the-scene look at his brother's pad. We talk to one of the Caribbean's leading cricket commentators, and also some key people on the beach of Maracas Bay, and the new CEO of the Queen's Park Oval, where it will all take place. Stay tuned, you wouldn't want to miss a minute of it. It's the Limacol CPL Weekly, and we are coming out to play.
Caribbean Premier League Weekly will be right back.
And in other 2020 cricket news, CPL T20 singers and musicians are set to arrive any day now.
It's how we play.
Play cricket for West Indies is hard work. That's why you need the best shoes.
Bowling fast is harder than it looks. And don't forget batting, I can do that too.
You need to have the best equipment to achieve optimum results.
Being in the center, all eyes are on me. Gotta look my best.
For over three decades, Sports and Games Barbados Limited has been outfitting professional, amateur, and young athletes with the best gear. Whatever your sporting needs, you are sure to meet them there. Corner of James and Roebuck Street.
Sports and Games, we are the home of champions.
When you are insured with United Insurance, you know you're in safe hands because our AM Best Excellent rating means that we have the financial strength and stability to protect your prized possessions. Rely on the company that understands your needs for property, motor, business, and marine insurance. For all your general insurance needs, choose United Insurance.
It's how we play.
The 1.3 million people who live in this 1900 square mile Twin Island Republic will tell you Trinidad and Tobago is the entertainment capital of the Caribbean. It's the birthplace of calypso, soca, steel pan, chutney and parang. David Rudder's Rally Round the West Indies is universally acclaimed as the anthem for West Indies cricket.
sweeps. He's hit it very well indeed.
Among Trinidad and Tobago's tourist attractions are the Queen's Park Savannah, Maracas Bay, the Caroni Bird Sanctuary, the Royal Botanical Gardens, and the Pariah Falls. Trinidad and Tobago also lays claim to two Nobel Prize winning authors, V.S. Naipaul and solution-born Derek Walcott. On the track and field scene, Hazley Crawford wrote his name in the history books by becoming the first man from the Caribbean to win the men's 100 meters at the 1976 Olympics in Montreal. Last summer at the London Olympics, 19-year-old Kishorn Walcott became the first person from the Western Hemisphere in 40 years to win the men's javelin.
And the 19-year-old set a new national record to win Trinidad and Tobago's first in-a-field event.
In football, Trinidad and Tobago became only the second English-speaking country to qualify for the finals of the World Cup in 2006. In cricket, Brian Lara has been afforded the status of a prince, hereafter rewriting the record book several times over a glittering career. Lara learnt his early cricket at Queen's Park Oval, a venue that has hosted 58 Test matches and 61 One Day Internationals, the most by any ground in either format in the Caribbean. Come Saturday the 24th, the Oval will also stage the first Limacol CPL final. Well, we're now talking with Richard Mauser. He's the new Chief Executive Officer of the Queen's Park Cricket Club. Richard, first of all, congratulations on your new post. How are things shaping up for the Caribbean Premier League? I know for sure that the ground and the outfit is going to be looking nice.
Well, we've just come out of the end of a long season, which has just finished. So there are a few spots that have to be worked on, but you know, this is what we do, and our time frame is to address that those issues and to be ready for that target date.
For some reason, cricket is always electrifying in Trinidad and at the Queen's Park Cricket Club. What is the secret? Is it because Trinidad is such a party kind of country?
Queen's Park Oval is 126 years old, and so we're steeped in tradition and history, and all of that comes out with an eclectic population, and we support our cricket very passionately. In recent times, with the success of our homegrown players, Queen's Park, with Pollard, Narayan, the Bravo brothers, you know, it certainly adds to the whole atmosphere. In cricket in the region, there are now a lot of stadium that we compete with. So we don't get all the cricket we used to get years ago. So it's important from a club point of view that, you know, that we provide a wide variety so that we can continue to be vibrant and hopefully another 100 years.
But behind every great team and every great player, there comes a fan. None more dedicated in the West Indies than Peter Matthews. One man who will be coming out to play in the Limacol Caribbean Premier League. You would have seen him on your television screens several times when West Indies are playing. You might not know his name, but his trademark stands out. Peter Matthews is one of cricket's biggest supporters. His long hats in all colours and designs make him a target of television directors. For several years, Peter has travelled around the Caribbean and gone beyond, journeying to England, Australia, South Africa, India, Sri Lanka, and other places around the globe to rally round the West Indies. When the West Indies lifted the 2012 T20 World Cup in Sri Lanka, he was there. Win, lose or draw, he is there. Let's hear his interesting story.
Well, things are quiet now at the Queen's Park Oval here in Trinidad and Tobago, but one man who's sure to lively things up come the CPL is none other than Peter Matthews, the man with the tall hat, the super fan of them all, king of fans, you can call him. I can go on and on. But Peter, first of all, what has inspired you to wear all these hats around the world? We see you in Australia, India, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, well, Pakistan about 4 or 5 years ago. But we see you all over when cricket is being played. You follow the West Indies and you're following CPL.
Yes, well, my friend Marjorie Morris from Jamaica first came to Trinidad and Tobago many years ago with one of these hats, and it had a reef on it, and I'm saying, you know, I normally wear hats, and I think this will be a good thing for me to wear because everybody know you on the cricket ground with your flags and so forth. And to add the hat tit, I think it finally put the icing on the cake. And from that moment on to today, 20-some years later, I'm wearing hats at the cricket grounds.
Where do you keep these hats in your house? I mean, is your closet tall enough?
I have a special drawer, you know, and it's overflowing right now because I have something like a 30-something hats, you know, so I put all them in one cupboard and it stays there all the time.
You seem really dedicated to following cricket around the world. You've seen a lot of T20 cricket. What has inspired you to be such a super fan where cricket is concerned and devote all your time to being a full-time fan?
Well, you know, when I first started to watch cricket, I started to watch cricket on the great run. Kanai, Clive Lloyd, you know, and these guys. We had good fast bowlers in those days. So those guys, you know, inspired to come and watch the game. And then when Brian Lara came into the scene, you never know. Brian Lara is a madman, you know. You never know when he give you 100. I think it inspired to go to cricket ground because you know on any given day he will actually give you 100.
It's in the air. Is it going? It's going. Yes, it's gone.
So I think that is where it all started from. And then when he decided to rack up those 100 one behind the next, I think it's something that you will never forget. So that is where the inspiration came from in the early days. And then Brian Lara just take it to a different level.
Caribbean Premier League is going to be big. Trinidad and Tobago, they have the luxury of hosting the semi-finals and the final. What can we expect the atmosphere and the whole aura to be like come CPL semis and final time?
Well, I'm hoping it to be just as how it is in the IPL. We are still trying to find out who are the stars that will be playing for Trinidad and Tobago. I'm backing the Trinidad and Tobago team, whoever the stars are in the team. Trinidad and Tobago have a good team, and we have to look and see who the final 15 will be playing for Trinidad and Tobago.
Well, look, CPL is definitely here. Look out for this man with the tall hat. When CPL time comes around, he's not just going to be here in Trinidad and Tobago, he's going to be around the Caribbean. We'll be right back.
When we come back on the Limacol CPL Weekly, we head to Santa Cruz.
It's how we play.
Yeah.
It's how we play.
Playing cricket for West Indies is hard work. That's why you need the best shoes.
Bowling fast is harder than it looks. And don't forget batting. I can do that too.
You need to have the best equipment to achieve optimum results.
Being in the center, all eyes are on me. Gotta look my best.
For over three decades, Sports and Games Barbados Limited has been outfitting professional, amateur and young athletes with the best gear. Whatever your sporting needs, you are sure to meet them there. Corner of James and Roebuck Street.
Sports and Games, we are the home of champions.
When you are insured with United Insurance, you know what it feels like to feel this safe. Choose the financially strong regional insurance company with the strength and stability to protect your prized possessions. For property, motor, business, and marine insurance, you're in safe hands with United Insurance.
It's how we play.
Dwayne Bravo and Darren Bravo are household names in Trinidad and Tobago. Between them, they have played more than 300 matches for the West Indies. Dwayne is the new West Indies One International captain. Darren is said to have the potential to be a world-class batsman in a few years. John Bravo is perhaps not a household name, but he is the father of the Bravo brothers.
Well, we are at the home of Darren Bravo, and with me is his dad, John Bravo. You know, John, it's a great pleasure to be in Santa Cruz. I've always heard so much about this lovely little town. You know, you're the father of not one, but two current West Indies players. How much satisfaction does that give you?
Well, that gives me a lot of satisfaction. Feel proud about the two boys.
When they were growing up, did you always have an indication that cricket would have been their preferred sport?
Yes, of course. As you know, that Dwayne was first, right? And I used to take some boys, plus with my big son, to Harvard on Sunday mornings, about 12 of them. And when Dwayne was 5 years, I took him to Harvard too, because I see the interest in cricket. And I say, he will play test cricket.
And when Derek came on the scene, did you see that same measure of talent and potential in him?
Of course. When he was in primary school, at age 7, Dwayne took Darren to play a final for Santa Cruz Primary School in Arima. And the first time Santa Cruz beat Arima in Premier League cricket. Yeah, yeah. At that time, Darren is about leg break.
Everyone talks about the similarities of Brian Lara, where Darren is concerned. And you look at the fact that they are from the same neighborhood. They're actually cousins. The relationship, has that always been strong because of where they're from in Santa Cruz and also because there's a family link with Darren?
Yeah, well, the relationship always strong, right? Because Darren, as you said before, is blood cousin to Brian. And for me, it's just a stone throw from here where Brian born, right? So it's that close.
You can't help but notice how neat and tidy Darren always looks. So it was no surprise when his mum allowed this. All right, well, we're going to get a behind the scenes look now. We're going to get a tour of Darren Bravo's room. How does this little cricketer who has impressed so many around the world keep his bedroom? Well, this is his lovely mother, Earlene, and his dad, John. They're going to give us the tour. Let's go, guys.
Oh, Lord.
All right. Interesting stuff. Well, look at this. Everything young Darren Bravo has folded. I'm sure, Mom, that you've done this for him.
No. I can't do it. I can't do this. My own hair neat like this.
Darren Bravo is a very neat youngster. And you can see it the way he bats. And look at it. All the bats, all the souvenirs, everything kept in pristine condition. All the shirts well pressed. Does he press his own clothes to Mom?
No. When I wash, I carry to the laundry to iron.
When you look over his bed, you can see all of the cricket shots, the cricket memorabilia.
No, I don't understand, you know. So as I put him to take all the picture, I had to run to catch him because he would have fallen long. You understand? He was no learning to stand there.
Tell me about these shoes. We can see that Darren obviously likes colorful shoes.
Oh, yeah, nice some. Yeah, look at the others here.
We are both size. So I got to take shoes around.
Mom, you should feel very proud of what...
Yes, when he clean up, I can't clean up like he. Yeah, he cleaning the kitchen or anything. Yeah, he neat.
Well, we know that he's training hard right now as they prepare for the Champions Trophy. But he has a long year ahead of him with so much cricket to play. Do you miss him?
Of course, yes. Yes, I miss him.
So when you miss Darren, do you just come in his room and just like...
No. I doesn't really come inside here. Only if I had to drop something, you know. And I doesn't want nobody inside it neither. To make no mess.
But he doesn't mind?
No. No, he don't mind.
But what about his brother, Dwayne? He's all ready for the Limacol CPL.
It's a great opportunity for a lot of regional players to make a name for themselves. And not everybody have the opportunity to play IPL, play Big Bash, and play those big leagues. But we can see 2020 coming to the Caribbean. The atmosphere, the Caribbean-like atmosphere it have in the Caribbean is going to be fun. I'm going to be excited. And I can't wait to be a part of it and get it on.
As you mentioned, you played in the IPL and the Big Bash and all the other 2020 leagues. Are you really happy that the Caribbean has finally launched their own version?
Yes, I'm very happy. I must say, WICB and to all those who put it on together, kudos must go to them. And it's not an easy tournament to put on. As you can see, a lot of tournaments, 2020 tournaments, play all over the world. And, you know, each tournament has its hiccups. I expect this one to do well. There will be hiccups, but it's good that we actually start our own league and let the world come to us. In this format of the game, we create some of the best styles of playing and develop some of the best players. We have some of the best players in the world from the Caribbean. So it's good that we have our own league and like I said before, invite players from other countries to come and be a part of it. And we all know that international players love playing in the Caribbean. And we just hope that it can be a successful tournament. It's a great opportunity for the young West Indian players to share just a room with those great players and learn from them. And myself, obviously, are looking forward to it. And it's a great opportunity to play in the same team with them. And, I'm very excited. Words can explain. I know it's going to be fun. The five other icons also are looking forward to it. And just hopefully it's going to be a successful one.
When we come back on the Limacol CPL Weekly, we hear from one of the Caribbean's leading commentators and some key people in the tourism industry.
It's how we play.
Yo!
We have come to play.
Yo, we here too.
We have come to play!
We've come to play!
Hey, don't forget about us, mate!
Yeah.
You know why we're here.
We always play!
This is how we play!
You playing? You better be. Check CPLT20.com and join the party.
We play it.
Play cricket for West Indies is hard work. That's why you need the best shoes.
Bowling fast is harder than it looks. And don't forget batting. I can do that too.
You need to have the best equipment to achieve optimum results.
Being in the center, all eyes are on me. Gotta look my best.
For over three decades, Sports and Games Barbados Limited has been outfitting professional, amateur, and young athletes with the best gear. Whatever your sporting needs, you are sure to meet them there. Corner of James and Roebuck Street.
Sports and Games, we are the home of champions.
When you are insured with United Insurance, you know you're in safe hands because our AM Best Excellent rating means that we have the financial strength and stability to protect your prized possessions. Rely on the company that understands your needs for property, motor, business, and marine insurance. For all your general insurance needs, choose United Insurance.
It's how we play.
From an era where there are so many stories, unfortunately, we didn't have all of the live television coverage that we have now, that we could just simply go into the archives, pull it up and say, oh, he faced not three deliveries, but he faced four. We forgot about that one. So many years ago.
But I've got some footage at home, don't worry.
Fazer Mohammed is Trinidad and Tobago's leading cricket commentator. For several years, we've heard his voice on various stations, giving you the ball-by-ball action when the West Indies are playing. He's also done television duties, and Fazer is also an experienced newspaper writer and shares his frank views on a range of issues in West Indies cricket. Now, we get his take on the Limacol Caribbean Premier League.
It's another exciting development in T20 cricket in the Caribbean. We've been exposed to the Stanford 2020. We've had the Caribbean T20 for a number of years. And this is an evolution, if you'd like, because more and more the world is moving towards the franchise-based system in T20 cricket. And it affords us really a lot of exciting opportunities to see the game being played for a concentrated period throughout a number of territories in the Caribbean. And certainly a lot of excitement will be generated merely because T20 cricket itself is an excitement package in its own right, and now to have other dimensions brought into it over a period of a few weeks certainly generates a tremendous amount of excitement. When you look at the competition, of course, people would automatically look to Trinidad and Tobago or the Trinidad and Tobago based franchise to see how well they perform, but because you've got the talent spread around the region, it allows certainly for a much more open competition. You've got certain templates that have been set up. You've got your IPL, you've got your Big Bash, you've got the English T20, which was the first to get going almost 10 years ago now. So really you've got a situation where the bar has been set. The challenge now is to see if the West Indies effort, the Caribbean T20 effort, can really match or exceed what we've seen before.
Like Mohammed, there are other people with key thoughts. Jimmy Diamond, for example, has been a man on Maracas Bay plying his trade for years. He is excited about the Limacol CPL.
It's in the Caribbean here, we got the raw talent, but you know what we don't have? Patience and discipline. You understand? And there's nothing without that. Right now we are waiting on the 2020 coming to Trinidad. Yeah, and I'm waiting right here patiently, and when you all come Maracas, I will show you all the best time. You understand? Let all you know, Trinidad is one of the best Caribbean countries in the world. Trust me. Jimmy Diamond says so.
Before we go, let's tell you about the matches in this year's Limacol CPL.
This is how we play the game.
This is how we play.
Show them who we stand for. Let's turn it up and light the
That's it for another week in this edition of the Limacol CPL Weekly. Join us again next week. I'm Barry Wilkinson.
It's how we play.